Good evening, YouTube. So I'm taking a look inside my variable AC power supply here. I'm getting ready to install this PZEM-021 AC panel meter, and that was going to replace the 061 meter that I had in here. And I thought the installation would pretty much be a plug and play. The only thing I had to install on the 061 meter was I took this wire off the ammeter here and ran it through the current transformer, and I thought I could just simply cut this wire and run this current in and out of the panel meter here. So it shows here's your load current on the outside. So I thought I could just run that load current through there. But one of the things I want to do with this meter is I want to power this meter separately from the variable voltage so that I can read the voltage down to 0 volts. To do that requires a little modification, and I'll show you this in a separate video. But what I need to do is disconnect this capacitive dropper, which is the power supply for this meter, and feed this bead on the capacitor separately from this input connector. So I have to run a fifth wire out of here, basically, and I'll show you that in a bit. But what that means is I've got constant voltage coming in here, and then in the center I've got line and neutral that the meter is reading the voltage of. So I've got basically two line connections, but I've only got one neutral connector. So now all of a sudden it matters which of these pins is line and neutral, because on this wiring diagram they actually don't label which one is line and neutral, because if you wire it up like this, as long as you got line on one side, neutral on the other side, it really doesn't matter which is which. So I'll show you a little diagram of this in a bit, but the other thing that matters is what is line and neutral inside of this power supply. How is it wired? So here's your incoming power cord. Got your green earth or ground wire, and then these two wires, the line and neutral, come in, and down here there's a fuse, so the line goes through the fuse. Then down at the bottom there's a double pole switch, and those wires run over here to the isolation transformer. So there's the 120 volt winding down here, and then there's an isolated with a plastic insulator, a separate 120 volt winding up here. So these are the isolated line and neutral connections. That comes over here to your Variac. This is where you get your variable voltage. This is the neutral connection, and then 120, so I actually labeled them neutral and line. And then this pin here picks up wherever this sliding contact picks up voltage, all the way from zero clear around to 150 volts roughly. Yeah, there, I tipped up the power supply a little bit. So here's your ammeter wire, comes from the variable voltage on the Variac to the ammeter, and then the ammeter, the other side, goes over to the power plugs, the receptacles, and feeds the hot terminal. And then the neutral terminal comes over here to the voltmeter. So the voltmeter sits between the hot and the neutral, or line and neutral, on the receptacles. And then there's a fuse down there. Right down here is a fuse. And then that comes back over to here to complete the circuit. So that's your isolated neutral. And then this is your isolated variable voltage to your plugs here. So let me show you a little diagram I drew up that hopefully will show what we've got here. So here's the variable supply. You've got your incoming line and neutral. There's a fuse, a double pole switch. This is your isolation transformer. And then over here, you've got your line and neutral connection at the Variac. Here's the sliding contact, goes through the ammeter. Over here's your voltmeter between the line and neutral. Here's your two receptacles, the line, the neutral, back through the fuse, back to the Variac. That's your variable output side. And then here's the panel meter, and here's the four terminals. So here's the backside of the meter. Here's your four terminals. This is your line side. Both of these are tied together. This is your neutral side, and this is a 1 milliohm resistor. So here's your 1 milliohm sense resistor, an R001. And then these two terminals are right here, shorted together. That's your line. This feeds a 1 microfarad capacitor, which is this yellow thing, and then a 51 ohm resistor here. And this basically feeds your power supply that powers this meter. So you can see this meter has the current sensing on the neutral side. It picks up the load back through the sense resistor and back to the neutral. This power supply has the sensing ammeter on the line side. So what I need to do is I've actually got to cut two wires. So I've got to cut the ammeter wire. This will be my line connection down here. The other side of the wire that I cut will go back in here. That'll be connected back together because these two pins are shorted right there. And then I'll have another cut in the wire. This side is the load returning, and then this side of the wire is the neutral. The load here is whatever you plug into your outlets here, and there should be another ground. So these are your two receptacles, and then here's your, this is your power. So here's my power connection. So this way the meter will be powered by 120 volts all the time. So yeah, it gets a little bit complicated because this power supply is set up with sensing, current sensing on the line side. This meter is set up with current sensing on the neutral side. And with this Variac, everything's referenced to the neutral. The neutral is the only thing that stays constant. The big thing is I want to see on this meter, I want to have 0 volts, 0 amps, and 0 watts. I want 3 zeros showing on there. So that's the goal of this project. We'll take a look at that when I get to cutting some wire. So yeah, if you have any questions about that, post up in the comment section below. And stay tuned for the next video. You can subscribe to the channel to be notified when that video is posted. And as always, thanks for watching.